We ready? Is that a yes?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. What are we doing? Yeah, answer. Enthalpy, thank you. What is enthalpy? Change in heat. So we are going to measure heat, and we're going to measure in particularly Q sub P, where P here means constant pressure. We like constant pressure because it means it has no lids on it. It means stuff doesn't explode. And what we want is straightforward. We want the change in enthalpy. And if we have enthalpy and we have delta H, remember that delta H is not Q. Delta H is our enthalpy, and it is heat normalized per mole in units of kilojoules per mole. That is what we are looking for in this. So we're going to measure a Q, we're going to put it into kilojoules, and then we're going to divide by moles to get enthalpy in kilojoules per mole for a very specific reaction. We want to know if we take sodium acetate as a solid and we add three waters to it, three waters exactly, as a liquid, and it goes into a hydrated NaC2H3O2 with three waters in it as a solid, meaning it's not soggy, it's a solid, we want the delta H. That would be really tough to figure out exactly how much water to add to this solid to make another solid with water in it. It's called a hydrated salt. So instead of doing the experiment, we are going to cheat. And we're going to cheat by using Hess's law. So this is what we're going to do instead. We're going to do Hess's law. Instead of doing this one, we're going to measure two other ones. We're going to take sodium acetate as a solid. We call this the anhydrous, meaning without water. We're going to put it into water. Water will be our medium and part of the surroundings for this process, and it's going to break into our sodium and our acetate. And we're going to measure the heat on this one. And then we're going to do the sodium acetate trihydrate, which is the hydrated crystal. Note it's also a solid. We're going to put it into our water, and we're going to let it dissociate as well until we make our sodium and our acetate and our three waters. These are the two things we are going to do. We're going to then use these two balanced equations to get the one that we want. So, please tell me, using Hess's law, if I call this equation 1 and I call this equation 2, how am I going to combine equations 1 and 2 to get the equation I want? I'm going to reverse 2. If I take this equation and I reverse it, so let's imagine I do that. If I do that, I'm going to have Na plus the acetate, plus three waters. We good? What's going to happen to the sodium and the acetate if these are my two equations now? My sodium and my acetate are going to cancel out. And I'm going to take this, I'm going to stick the waters to it. I'm going to get sodium acetate trihydrate as a solid. Regardless of the fact we are not going to do that experiment, we're doing these two. But if I take my data from equation 2, reverse it, and add it to my data for equation 1, I will get what I need. We good? So with that in mind, we need to do the experiment. And what we're going to measure are the heats, not the enthalpies. We're going to go from the heats into the enthalpy. We know that heat Q is equal to the mass times the specific heat capacity times the delta T, and we know the sign of delta T matters. We know that delta T is equal to T final minus T initial. And we know that the mass of this is the mass of the entire thing. So please realize the mass is going to be the mass of the water plus the salt plus your nice ionic compound. Those are going to add together for the mass. The specific heat capacity is given. Delta T you will measure with a thermometer. This, by the way, will be the Q for the surroundings. We do not ever measure Q for a reaction. We measure how much heat the surroundings have gained or lost. If we know that the Q for the surroundings, let's say, is endothermic by some value, then the Q of the system will be exo, change the sign, and the same value. So we're going to do that two times, realizing that our mass is going to be equal to the sum of the water plus the ionic compound. That's going to give us Q. All we have to do then is normalize it. Normalize it means we're going to take Q, our heat, for the reaction. We're going to put this into kilojoules, and we're going to divide by the moles. Please be careful and realize that what we want are the moles of the ionic compound. So do not use the mass of the water and the salt. Go over here and do the moles of the ionic compound of the salt only. Once you have your two delta H values, you can take equation 2, reverse it, and add. And we'll pretty much do the entirety of chapter 6 in one simple experiment. In terms of the experiment, really straightforward. You're going to grab yourself a nice fat test tube, which you're going to clean, yes? Good. Clean it well with deionized water. These are big enough that we can actually dry them. So when you've got this nice and clean, please take and put a paper towel into it and actually dry it out. All right? And you may have to wrap it around and put it on a stirring bar, but either way, you can get your test tube dry. Once your test tube is nice, or your nice fat test tube is dry, we're going to do our experiment with it. We have to weigh out our two ionic compounds. Oh, and by the way, when you get your paper towel stuck, just bring it up to your teacher. We can get them unstuck. That's what we do for a living. Nice, clean, fat test tube. You're going to need a thermometer. Obviously, your supplies are in the back. We're going to weigh out our two compounds. Now, our two compounds look differently. The anhydrous is a powder. The hydrate is a?
Solid.
They're all solids. The hydrate looks like salt or sugar. And the other one looks like almost like powdered sugar. One's a powder, and the other looks like salt. If you do the same compound, obviously, they're going to look the same. Make sure you get two different ones. When you weigh this, please use your weighing rules, meaning put your piece of weighing boat, your weighing boat on it, hit the read zero button. Give it a moment. There we go. Good. Hit the ReZero button. And when you've done that, please try not to weigh on top of the weighing dish, on top of the balance, because you'll just spill. I would prefer it if you took and you weighed a little over on the side, figured out how much that works out to be. And in this case, this is about 0.18 grams. I need 1.2. And then just add it in bits until you get pretty close to what you need. When you do that, you need to record the mass to every sig fig that is on your balance. So when I'm finished with this, I'm going to get on the order of about 1.2 grams of this. And when I've got about 1.2 grams of this, I'm ready to do my experiment. All right. So pretending I have 1.2 whatever grams, I'm going to come over here. And all I'm going to need is 10 mils of deionized water. So you get yourself some water. Get a nice graduated cylinder. Fill it after you've cleaned it to 10 mils. When you've filled it to 10 mils, you need to know what its temperature is. So put a thermometer in it. Get the temperature. The temperature is going to be whatever this is. I got 22.0 degrees Celsius. At that point, you will do the experiment. The experiment you will take, add your solid to your nice fat test tube, add your deionized water, trying to get it off the sides if you possibly can, and then stir it. With the thermometer, because why not? It's going to change. I will let you know that one of these is endo and one of these is exo. One of these will get colder, endothermic. One of these will get warmer, exothermic. Record your values. I started at 22. I am now at over 26 degrees Celsius. So write those down. When you've got that done and it stops changing, so when do you stop stirring? As soon as it stops changing, it'll take about 2 minutes. We have everything we need. We have the mass of the water, 10 mils, 10 grams. We have the mass of the salt, whatever you weighed out. Specific heat capacity is given. This is T final minus T initial. My solution got warm, therefore my reaction lost heat. Are we good? When you're done, normalize it to moles, put the two together, make it work. We good?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Goggles on, have fun.